My name is Ravikumar. I am the Deputy Director of Research at the St. Louis Fed. So if you look at the worldwide trends in population, it took thousands and thousands of years to get to the first billion. So we reached the first billion in 1803. Then it took another 125 years to get to the second billion. So about 1928, we got to the second billion. After that, it was a mere 32 years, we got added the third billion. So the world population has been accelerating, slowly approaching 8 billion, and we might have even crossed it by now. Population growth rate can be increasing due to one of two things. It's basic accounting. So it's either the birth rate went up or the death rate went down. Population growth rate, by definition, is birth rate minus death rate. So the old theories, the Malthusian theories, were predicting population growth and linking it to economic development. So as economies developed, they got richer, the population increased. So that was the story. Now, that story doesn't seem to hold water, because if you look at a cross-section of countries now, even the poor countries' population is increasing. So the departure from Malthusian theory is due to Becker. And Becker predicted that as economies developed, the birth rates would fall. So his story was economic development had to change the opportunity cost of time. The reason why it's the change in the opportunity cost of time is each worker is more productive as part of the economic development. So each unit of time earns him more money. As the opportunity cost of time increases, the birth rates fall because children take time to take care of. So children become costlier as economies develop because the opportunity cost of time increases. Since the economic development implies higher opportunity costs, the birth rate falls. This is true both in the cross-section that you see in terms of poor countries versus rich countries now. It's also true when you look at historical evidence for any particular country going back to 18th, 19th, or 20th centuries. But the problem is, if the birth rates are falling, population growth rate should also fall. That's not true in the data. So that's the puzzle. Why is the population growth rate increasing despite the fact that the birth rates are falling? Okay, so then the question is, the burden has to be on the death rate to solve the puzzle, because it must be the case that the death rate is declining faster than the birth rates. That's the only way the population growth rate can increase, purely as a matter of accounting. So the Malthusian story is death rates decline due to economic development. As countries get richer, death rates decline. That story doesn't hold any water, because even poor countries' death rates are declining. In fact, the death rates for the poor countries is approaching that of the rich countries. So even though they're nowhere near the economic development of the rich countries. So what could the death rate decline be due to if not economic development? So the popular stories are it's due to the advent of modern medicine like penicillin, or due to the advent of public health infrastructures. While these stories have merit, that doesn't seem to explain quantitatively the overall decline in the death rates. Now, that could be due to the fact that simple practices that have been adopted by population has been ignored. Simple practices like washing hands, using soap, etc., has diffused through the population over many, many years, and that has contributed to bulk of the decline that you see in mortality rates. Visit stlouisfed.org for more information.